Want to get back your old add-ons? Head over to your local browser and download GM Publisher. Just do a quick little Google search or go to the link provided in the description. Once there, head over to the releases page where there will be three options for what to download. The MSI version with these two zips, which are for Linux and Mac. Don't ask me what Mac version, because the tutorial here is just for Windows. That being said, go over and download the MSI file and open it. Windows will say that the file is not safe, but that's just because it doesn't have a publisher certificate attached to it. So just press more info and run anyway. Then go through the setup as you would for any other installer. Once finished, head over to your start menu and open GM Publisher. This program uses files from Steam and GMod in order to retrieve its information such as your user and your published add-ons. But we don't care about that, just click on Installed Add-ons and you'll see your list of add-ons. If you see these icons with the dead directory logo, that's an add-on that's been deleted by Steam that you still have installed locally. If you want to restore this add-on, click on the add-on and press Extract. This will give the option of where to extract it. Just go to your add-ons folder. Once done, this file explorer will open, showing you its extracted location. Pay attention to the add-on's path, the path being add-ons and then the extracted add-on with the subsequent materials and models. This is the way it should look. It should not be add-ons, some kind of buffer folder, and then your add-ons folder. Just keep this in mind if you ever go downloading add-ons anywhere else. Now you can go ahead and open GMod. Oh, Steam says the game is already running? Remember I mentioned before that GM Publisher uses GMod's files? So go close GM Publisher, as Steam will see that as the game currently running. Oh, one last thing. Let's head on over to the workshop and make sure you are subscribed to the Extended Spawn Menu add-on. This add-on will make sure that our legacy add-ons contained in folders will be used in-game. Once you open the game, you may see this extracting, downloading, hidden add-on stuff. Don't worry about that, we'll get to it later. Now you can just go ahead and launch a map. Once you're in, open your spawn menu and you'll see this little drop-down called Add-ons Legacy. As you can see, the add-on I extracted from GM Publisher, being SMD4 Dolls, has extracted perfectly. But that's all there is for props, what about maps? Maps follow the same extraction process as other add-ons, except you cut the maps folder out of the initial folder that GM Publisher creates, and you paste it into your Garry's Mods root folder. And there's no need to do anything with the materials and models that may come with your map. Just leave them in the add-ons folder. And as you can see, the maps work perfectly. That's just about it though for restoring taken down add-ons. Oh, right, and those hidden add-ons mentioned earlier. Those are all the add-ons that have been taken down that you currently still have installed, since whenever an add-on is taken down, it of course doesn't delete the file. But nobody wants to be annoyed by this every single time they open the game, so the fix to this is to just go uninstall those add-ons after you restored them. Just go to your add-ons page and search for hidden add-on, select all of them, and uninstall. It's as simple as that. Oh, good reminder. Luckily there's an archive Discord server made where you can get all the add-ons that fellow users have uploaded. A bit too many Splatoon add-ons there though.